Hello everyone, I am D.R. Somoshi from CIPL Pune. In this session, we are going to understand how to prepare educational videos with smart tools. First, we will see the different smart tools available on the internet that we can easily download and use for video recording and editing. And then we will see the CamStudio, which is one of the most simplest and powerful video recording tools available. We move further with the uses and benefits of CamStudio. We'll see the different program options, program settings in CamStudio, and then we'll see how to record and play video with CamStudio. So let's start with PowerPoint presentation. So as I discussed, we are going to understand preparing educational videos with smart tools. So these are the contents of this session. First, we are going to focus on smart screen and video recording tool. Then we will focus on CamStudio, how to record audio, video and screen with CamStudio, and I will demonstrate you how to record and play the videos. Smart screen and video recording tools. These are the list of smart screen and video recording tool. FreeCam, DVD VideoSoft, Free Screen Video Recorder, ShareX, CamStudio, Mojave Screen Recorder, Smart Screen Recorder, then again EZVid, CamStashia, TinyTake, iSpringSuit, Filmora Screen, OBS Studio, VSDC Video Editor. All these tools are used for creating or recording videos. Some of the tools are used for creating videos and some of the tools are used for editing the videos. Some tools are specially designed for developer. Some of the tools are only designed for game recording. Some of the tools are free to use and some of the tools are paid, that you have to pay for that. So we are moving towards the CamStudio, which is one of the open source and free video recording tool. So CamStudio is open source and free recording tool. It is used to record screen with audio video, which is used for creating industry standard AVI video file, but which can also be used for creating flash videos, MP4 videos, etc. We will see the benefits and uses of CamStudio. CamStudio is specially used for creating demonstration videos, answering frequently asked questions, creating video tutorials for school or college classes, providing technical support, providing video based product information, etc. For any of these, you can use CamStudio effectively. While using CamStudio, you have to follow some steps. First, you have to download and install CamStudio. Then you have to understand the different program settings. Then you can record videos and then finally you can play the videos. To download and install the CamStudio, you have to browse camstudio.org website, or you can search for CamStudio on Google and go to camstudio.org website. Then you can download the CamStudio and then you can install by double clicking on that installed file. So this is the default screen of CamStudio. Then after installing, then you have to understand the different program settings. One of the most important program setting is window capture or capture region. Here you have to specify the region of capture, means you have to specify what to record, whether you want to record full screen video, all activities of screen, or whether you want to capture only a particular window or particular region that you are going to specify. Then you have to specify whether you want to record your audio from microphone or speaker, whether you want to record your video from webcam, some program options available there, then keyboard shortcuts to start and stop the videos. Keyboard shortcuts is one of the important part through which we can start and stop the video recording, because whenever we are recording, the program will be in invisible state on screen. Through the keyboard shortcut, we can give the instructions to that program about starting and stopping the videos. Then you have to understand output directories of your Cam Studio. Once you record your video, the program is recorded, the video file is recorded on a particular location. The default location is specified by Cam Studio, but you can define your own locations also. So let's start with demonstrations. How to install Cam Studio and how to use Cam Studio. We'll see. To install Cam Studio, search for Cam Studio on Google. Then use camstudio.org link to download. If you click on this camstudio.org link, this page will appear. Here you have to click on this green button, download. Click here to download Cam Studio 2.7 version will be downloaded. Once you click on this button, a file will be downloaded on your machine and it will shown on your tray panel or status bar of Google Chrome. You have to double click on this file to install the Cam Studio and you have to follow the instructions. The Cam Studio will automatically install on your machine. After installing, you can open the Cam Studio. Cam Studio is already open in this machine. I am starting Cam Studio from start menu. After opening Cam Studio, a default screen of the Cam Studio will appear in front of you. Sometimes Cam Studio opens in tray panel of Windows operating system. I will show you how the tray panel works. See, this is tray panel icon, and in tray panel, Cam Studio is in any visible state. If you are not getting the Cam Studio program on screen, you can open from this tray panel icon. If you have to double click on this tray panel icon, the program will appear in front of you. So this is the basic structure of your Cam Studio program. We will see the different options which are there on this screen. First, we start with the toolbar options. On toolbar, the first three buttons are used to start, pause and stop the recording. These buttons are rarely used. Instead of this button, we are generally using the shortcut keys to start, pause and stop recording. The next button is to toggle between the menu bar and the Cam Studio screen. If I click on this toggle button, the Cam Studio screen will disappear. Again, if I click on this toggle button, the menu bar will disappear. Again, you can enable and disable the screen and menu bar using this toggle button. The next option is screen annotation. When I click on this button, a separate window will appear through which we can add the screen annotations. The screen annotations are not that much important. We will see it later on how to add the screen annotation. Then the next button on toolbar is used to specify the format of your recording. The first default format that you are seeing here is record to AVI, means this program will record in AVI format. If you want to change the recording format or your video format, you have to click on this button. If I click on this button, it will change the record format to SWO, means it is a flash format. Again, if you want to change this format, you have to click on this button again. Then it shows you the record to MP4 format. So in this way, you can toggle between the MP4, flash video and FLV video. Default is AVI, I am keeping this default option. And the last button on toolbar is used to use some add-on options in Cam Studio. This button is rarely used. Then we move further with menu bar. On menu bar, there are several menu options are there. First menu option is file, in which the same option record, pause and stop are there, which perform the same action that on the toolbar button. The next menu is region, in which the full screen option is currently selected. If you want to record the full screen video of your full screen video, then you have to select this full screen option. all the activities that you perform on full screen will be recorded. Instead of recording full screen, if you want to specify a particular window to record, you can choose this window option. And instead of using the particular window, if you want to specify a particular region, if you want to specify that particular region, you can specify the region like this by dragging the rectangle, and only you want to record from that region. So for that you can specify the region. For that you can specify the fixed region. If I click on this fixed region, it will display one window. Using this select button, you can specify the region of recording. The mouse pointer changes like this. You have to select the region of your recording by dragging the mouse. After pressing and releasing the mouse, the width and height parameter will automatically change. Means only the height and width is specified here. In that height and width, all the operation that you perform will only be recorded here. This option is rarely used. Then we move further forward with the next menu option, that is the option. In option menu, there are so many different menu options are there. First is video option. This video option is used to specify the video compression type or the video compressor type. The default video compressor type specified is Microsoft Windows, and you have to choose this Microsoft Windows, which is one of the most powerful video compression technology. You can use any other, but this is required. This is most useful and powerful. So I have selected this Microsoft video, and the quality of this video is specified here is 70%, or you can increase the increase or decrease the quality of your compression. Another options are set keep frames every 100 frames, capture frame every 50 milliseconds, playback rate, etc. These are already specified here, no need to set all these settings. Then the next option is cursor option. It is also an important option. If you want to highlight your cursor on screen in recorded video, then you have to show cursor. You have to select the show cursor option. And in show cursor option, the default show cursor option is selected, and inside it the use actual cursor option is selected. Instead of this actual cursor, if you want to use some custom cursor like this, you can use this option. Or instead of again this cursor, if you want to choose the cursor from file, you can choose this option. When you click on this browse button, the different cursor will be displayed to you, and you can use any cursor that you want. If I select this arrow question mark, then this cursor will be chosen in your video. Means while playing your video, whatever the cursor movement that you have performed, that is displayed with this cursor. Then you can highlight the cursor position with the cursor shape with the cursor shape and color. The default cursor shape to highlight the cursor is circle. Instead of circle, you can change ellipse, square, rectangle, etc. You can also change the color of highlight cursor. The default color is here yellow. You can change this color using this color option. Then the next option is audio option. This option is again important. To record your audio from your microphone, you have to choose this option, audio option for microphone. But before choosing audio option from before choosing this option, you have to specify which microphone you wanted to use for recording your audio. So I am selecting this option. After selecting, a window will appear in which you have to specify the default audio capture device specified here. You have to specify your specify your microphone, and then recording format is already specified there. You can choose the compressed format of your audio. Then you have to click on OK. Then the next option is audio option for speaker. If you want to record your audio from speaker, you have to choose this option. Then the next option is do not record your audio. Means if you select this option, you don't want to record your audio. And if you want to record your audio, you have to select this record audio from microphone option, which is already selected here. Then if you want to record audio from speaker, you have to select this option. Then another options are enable auto span speed, automatically stop recording. These are rarely used options. Some other options are available in program option. In program option, these four options need to be selected. These four options indicate you have to minimize program on start recording. Means once you start recording, your program should be in minimize mode. That Cam Studio will not be appear on your screen. Whatever the activities that you are performing on your screen, only that activities should be recorded. The Cam Studio program or the screen of the Cam Studio program should not be recorded. For that, this option is required. Again, the hide flashing rectangle during recording is again required. So you don't want to show the flashing rectangle during recording. Save setting on exit option is also required. Whatever you perform the setting, this setting should be saved for future use. And this capture translucent layered window is option is also required. Then in program options, some another necessary options are play AVI file when recording stop. This option is used to play the AVI file after your recording complete or completion of your recording. You can specify which player you want to use for playing your video file. The default video player is selected here, that is use Cam Studio player for 2.0. Instead of this player, you can use any player that you like Windows Media Player, VLC Media Player, etc. But you only have to know the location of your recording file. Then the next option are temporary recording directories, in which you can specify where the temporary files of your recording will be stored. So default is selected there. You need not to change this option also. Then the next important option is output directory. Again, this option is already selected there. Your default recording directory is the My Cam recording directory, and which is available in document. In document folder, you will find My Cam Studio videos folder, and in which all your recorded video will be available. If you want to change this folder, you can use this user specified directory option. Then the next option is recording thread priority. This is again no need to set. Name of the AVI file is again important. After completing your recording, it will ask for the file name. The default option is ask for the file name, means when you finish your recording or when you stop your recording, it will ask for the file name. And whatever you specify the file name in which the video will be stored. Or if you want to specify the automatic file naming using date and time, you can use this automatic file naming option. Then another most important option is keyboard shortcut. When I click on this keyboard shortcut option, one window will appear in front of you, in which you have to specify the shortcut keys for starting and stopping your recording. The default key specified here is F10 for start recording, and default key specified here is F11 for stop recording. So all other keys are not that much important. To cancel the recording, you can use this F12 key, etc. You can specify any combination of these keys, Control plus F10 or Control Alt plus F10, etc. So default is default specified here is F10. I am keeping all these settings as it is, or you can choose as per your requirement here. Then the next option in the option menu is language. No need to choose any language. And then we move toward the next menu option, that is tools. The tools menu is also important. In which the two options are there, screen annotations and video annotations. The screen annotations are not that much important. We'll see it further. We'll focus on video annotation. If you want to record your video from webcam, this option is needed. When I click on this option, one window will appear in front of you. Now it's saying Cam Studio was unable to detect a webcam or video source. Again, if such error is occurred, you have to simply close the Cam Studio, and again you have to open the Cam Studio. Sometimes such errors may occur. I'm again starting Cam Studio from start menu. Again I'm selecting this tools video annotation, At that time, this window is appear. When I selecting this tools video annotation options, this window is appear. In this window, you have to specify the video source from which you want to capture your video. There may be different videos. There can be different video source that is attached to your machine. You can attach microphone, you can attach a webcam to your machine, or you can attach your cell phone to your machine. If you are connecting two or more such video recording devices to your machine, you have to specify which video recording device you have to use for recording your video. Here, select a video device. I am selecting this Logitech. Four different devices are connected to this machine. I have connected two webcam to this machine and two mobile cam to this machine. So I am selecting this Logitech HD webcam C270 option. And when I click on this option, apply and OK, a video screen will appear in front of you. So you can move this window anywhere. You can keep this window on any side of your screen. You can change the size of this video also. To change the size of this video, you have to right click on this video and select the video format option. After selecting video format option, a window will appear. In that window, you have to specify the resolution of your window. The default resolution is 640 by 480. I am selecting here 320 by 240. When I click on apply and OK, the size of this video will automatically change. I am keeping that video on top right corner of window. Again, I am exit from the zoom option and keeping that video at the top right corner. Then you can now record your video with Cam Studio. Now Cam Studio is ready to record your videos. First, you have to check the keyboard shortcut to start and stop the recording. Again I am getting the keyboard shortcut for starting and stopping the recording. So I am moving toward the program option and selecting the keyboard shortcuts. Here the keyboard shortcut to start the recording is F10 and to stop the recording is F11. So these two keys I am going to use to start the recording. Now the Cam Studio is ready to record. I am going to minimize this program, so this program should not appear on screen while recording. Whatever the activities I will perform on my screen, those activities should be recorded without this Cam Studio screen. So for that, I am minimizing this Cam Studio program. If I am minimizing this Cam Studio program, program is in tray panel. It is not closed. It will accept your shortcut keys. Then I am starting. Then I am going to start the recording. To demonstrate a sample video, again I am going to present the same PPT I have presented earlier. Now I am pressing the F10 key. After pressing the F10 key, I think one more settings you have to specify. Here a window is appear. That window is saying that you have to specify the region of your recording. We have not specified the region of your recording, so I am again moving towards the Cam Studio option. Recording is started, but particular region is not selected. I am not saving that particular file. I am selecting the region as full screen. I want to specify the full screen recording. So after selecting this full screen recording, I am minimizing this option and again I am starting the recording with the F10 key. I am confirming that whether the recording is starting. The recording is now started. Now I am presenting this PPT. The recording is now started and I am going to present this PPT. Hello everyone, I am D.R. Somoshi and I am presenting this topic titled Preparing Educational Videos with Smart Tools. So these are the contents of this topic. These are the different smart tools available on internet that you can easily download, such as ZZ Video, Camstashia, TinyTech, iSpring, etc. Cam Studio is one of the most powerful and pre-screen recording tool which is used to record audio and video. Uses and benefits of Cam Studio. You have to follow these steps. To download and install Cam Studio, you have to follow these instructions. And let's see the demonstration. In this way, you can record your video. To stop the recording, I am again selecting the F11 key. After selecting the F11 key, a window will appear in front of you. That window will ask for the name of recording. I am specifying here the name of the recording is recording 1, record 1. After selecting this save button, the recording will be saved in this record 1 AVI file. Okay, and after that, a player is automatically opened. You can see here, Cam Studio player is automatically opened here. Through that player, you can play the videos like this. I am selecting this play button. So if I selecting this play button, this is the default video player of Cam Studio. I am selecting this play button. After selecting, the recording is now playing. Whatever the operation that I have performed here will be displayed one after another. So in this way, you can record your videos with Cam Studio. Then we will see where the recorded file is available. I am selecting this PC. I am selecting documents. Inside document, there is a folder called My Cam Studio Videos. If I select this folder, a record one file will be there. If you right click on it and if you open with any player that you like, I am selecting VLC Media Player. Now it will open that file in VLC Media Player. So this is now the recorded file. On top left corner your video is there and you are presenting the screen like this, etc. Hope you understand all these things. Now I will summarize the things that we have seen in this session. We have seen the different smart tools available on internet for using video recording. Then we focus on Cam Studio. We seen the different program options of Cam Studio along with benefits and uses of Cam Studio. And then we finally seen how to record and play the video with Cam Studios. Hope you understand all. Thank you very much.